time for some new items from Hiroshi Okamoto, now available outside of Japan. Finally, anybody, anywhere in the world can now order from the 2009 Spring and Summer Hiroshi Okamoto Collection. Vintage flight jackets, vintage helmets, vintage bikes, figures, and more. Here's a small sample of the collection. First up, the McHill Overall Docker shirt. This is the shirt the guys working on the railroad used to wear if they were working on the Santa Fe, the most famous train in the world, maybe even more famous than Thomas the Tank Engine. It's got the blue and white Santa Fe Railroad logo and the state flag of New Mexico. Santa Fe started out as a freight train in 1860, chugging its way from Kansas into Santa Fe, New Mexico. This shirt has buttons made of Bakelite, common for work shirts made back in the early days of railroading, and the union-made tag sewn into the fluted sleeves. In 1936, the Santa Fe built a new streamlined passenger train called the Super Chief, and it was an instant hit, like this shirt. Eh, what's up, Doc? Looks like a custom-painted Type A2 jacket from the mighty 8th Air Force, where Bugs Bunny was apparently mascot-in-chief. The mighty 8th, stenciled up there on the right breast. And on the left shoulder, the celebrated squadron's patch. Up there in the neck area, a sewn-in leather hanger. And a perfect reproduction of the Talon No. 7 zipper, reinforced with ribbons. Made extra strong to handle the stress and strain of flying reconnaissance missions. Ribbons and strong, straight stitches. You think Bugs Bunny volunteered for TDY in the mighty 8th Air Force Squadron? So do I. It was a tight outfit. Now comes the Type L2 test sample from Albert Turner in 1945. It's a full custom flight jacket with unlimited power. Loaded with patches that promote the hard-edged, unlimited class of fictitious championships. You know what I mean. This is a faithful reproduction of an experimental test sample. On the inside, the Albert Turner Manufacturing ID label. Nice details, like storm flaps and military brass fasteners. On the right breast, the 1964 Reno, Nevada National Air Race Championship patch. On the left, Mockbusters and unlimited class. Exquisite workmanship all around. There's a zippered pocket for a pack of smokes. Or if you quit, maybe a cell phone and pen pockets. Two more embroidered patches. And, of course, the white U.S. Air Force logo. There it is, high on the left shoulder above the functional pockets. And our old pal, the Tasmanian Devil. Way back in the early 1940s, the U.S. Navy issued a flight jacket for the summer season. They designated it the M421A. Here it is, with Felix posing as one wild cat. That's a decent-looking jacket. And judging by the foil-stamped sew-on leather name tag, one Lieutenant Robert Dibb wore this out on the flight deck. Hey, Felix, don't bogart that bomb, my friend. Inside, above the ID and spec label, a sewn-in hanger. On the Repro Talon zipper, a leather strap. On the back, nothing but the best, heavy-duty chain embroidery. Plus, a USN stencil on the front left snap button pocket. Okay, there's Felix again, this time on a McHill Overalls chambray shirt. Apparently, Felix was attached to the USS Yorktown. Nobody is more famous for ordering chambray shirts than the U.S. Navy. And they were union-made, of course. They featured stencils. Lots of stencils. Stencils are a Navy staple. Nothing like the feel of a well-made, well-stenciled chambray shirt, right, Felix? And now, back to everybody's favorite rabbit, flying reconnaissance. Reconnaissance. On a U.S. Army Air Force summer knit shirt. This one commemorates the Mount Farm Air Base, home of the mighty 8th Reconnaissance Squadron. It's nicely knit. with custom embroidery. Good for a softball game or whatever summer sport you like. Hey, next time you're out riding around on your steel horse, you might want to be wearing a Beck Black Cat motorcycle shirt just for the fun of it. When people ask, hey, ain't that Felix the Cat painstakingly embroidered on the back? You can tell them, yep, that's the original Felix, the way creator Pat Sullivan drew him in the beginning. It's a beautiful reproduction with snap buttons to match and a union label. Also nice to have on your ride is one of Beck's popular two-fold safety chain wallets. They're handcrafted, custom-made using a special tanning process. The tan one here is made of bridle leather with heavy-duty snaps, a heavy-duty zipper, and plenty of room for cards and cash. You might rather have a black one. It's pretty much the same. Except the black one is made of American Latico leather. Same snaps, same zipper, and same spacious cash cargo area. Now here's some boots to go with that Santa Fe Railroad worker shirt. The guys who laid the rails wore these. That's why they're called ironclad railman boots. They're slip-free thanks to the cat's paw sole that heals with the non-slip grip. Here's a V-Hilt model leather helmet bag made out of Mustang hide. Metal parts like the handle rivets and the strap clips are custom-made just for this bag. The Army Air Force Squadron logo, service number, and leather nameplate are hand-painted. Plenty of room in there for your helmet, gloves, and more. And there's the MGM Studios license, awarded to Hiroshi Okamoto to reissue this bag. If you're ready to make your great escape, take this bag with you. Motorcycle boots come in a lot of different fancy styles these days, but these are the original, real rugged riding boots. With cat's paw non-slip rubber soles and heels, good protection against slipping and sliding. These boots are tough. Carefully crafted from genuine double-tanned horsehide. They're a faithful reproduction of the 1940 model engineer boots from Beck, founded in 1914 in Old New York. A lot of people say the engineer boot is the only true motorcycle boot. Hey, before we go, let's check out some caps. Well, that's a pretty good collection. You probably saw at least one thing that you want, so hey, why not get it? And there's only one place to go. You can't buy direct from Hiroshi Okamoto, something about worldwide licensing restrictions. But you can get anything in the collection from Collezione Giappone in Japan, along with their first-class service. So when you're ready to order, and right now would be a good time to make sure you get what you want, most of this stuff won't last. When you're ready to order, just surf your way over to the Collezione Giappone website. There it is on your screen. And send them an email right from the site. Tell them what you want, and they'll get right back to you. And keep in touch, because there's a lot more to come. This video promo has been brought to you by Collezione Giappone S.P.A.